Hello, everyone. This is take three. I don't think the enemy wants me to put this video up. Although, I'm not sure how many views it'll get. If it helps one person, it'll be worth it. You know, with all this rioting in all the cities, you know, I watched a video earlier today from Dabu, someone sent me, saying there were 400 cities now that have been rioted, you know, gotten people sent there to riot and loot and so on. And we know that that is not about George Floyd. Those people are being respectful and quiet, carrying signs and doing it right to make a voice, you know, to state their point. Well, anyway, with all that going on, and I don't know what you're going through with the COVID, maybe nothing, maybe everything's like normal for you, but not for everybody. And I know there are some people that are feeling kind of down right now. And maybe you're one of them. And maybe you just don't understand why we're still here. Or does God really love me? Or have I actually really been forgiven? Or just exactly what am I to God? And why did this happen? Or why did that happen? I have to tell y'all, I've been a mess. And I'm being honest. And I know now that the Lord has been trying to get me to go to Isaiah 54. I've heard it from other people that they quoted one of the verses or something. But anyway, I'm going to read most of it, because the first three verses are not really like the last. They are in a way, but I don't fully understand them, so I'm going to move on to verse 4, which is a new paragraph, and I am in NASB. And I do pray that this will encourage many of you, if not in one way, then in another way. So I shall begin. Fear not, for you will not be put to shame. And do not feel humiliated, for you will not be disgraced. I couldn't get through this without crying earlier. I actually thought God had kind of stepped back. Not that he didn't love me, but that I've not been obedient enough to his words to me. I felt like maybe, and I wondered, you know, was I really hearing from you? And why don't I hear from you now? And what have I done wrong? And have I not witnessed enough here? You know, I thought maybe I should have went door to door and instead of just handing out stuff, you know, or putting it in their, you know, sliding it in their door. And anyway, so he says, fear not, for you will not be put to shame. And do not feel humiliated, for you will not be disgraced. But you will forget the shame of your youth and the reproach of your widowhood. You will remember no more. For your husband is your maker, whose name is the Lord of hosts, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. who is called the God of all the earth. For the Lord has called you like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit. Even like a wife of one's youth when she is rejected, says your God. I'll repeat that. Verse 6. For the Lord has called you like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, even like a wife of one's youth when she is rejected, says your God. I was rejected 3 times. For a brief moment, I forsook you, but with great compassion, I will gather you. In an outburst of anger, I hid my face from you for a moment, but with everlasting loving kindness, I will have compassion on you, says the Lord, your Redeemer. For this is like the days of Noah to me. And that's a capital M, excuse me. How fitting is this right now? How appropriate. This is, we are living like in the days of Noah. And the footnote says, some manuscripts read, the waters of Noah, this is to me. For this is like the waters of Noah. When I swore that the waters of Noah would not flood the earth again. And the footnote says, literally, cross over. So I have sworn that I will not be angry with you, nor will I rebuke you. For the mountains may be removed and the hills may shake, but my loving kindness will not be removed from you. And my covenant of peace will not be shaken, says the Lord. I'm being chewed on. Says the Lord who has compassion on you. O afflicted one, storm-tossed and not comforted, behold, I will set your stones in antimony, and your foundations I will lay in sapphires. Moreover, I will make your battlements of rubies. Let's see what battlements is. I think he's talking about how he's going to build our mansions. It can be masculine or feminine. From an unused root, meaning to be brilliant. And it translates into the word sun, sun rising, with H2 4217, or east side, that's where the sun rises. If it's used with H4217, it could be used windows, the windows. Well, that's probably what he means in this particular case. Down here in the what you'd call the outline, E is pinnacles, battlements, or shields. As glittering or shining. Okay, so that's a couple possibilities of what that means right there. What if our windows were made of rubies? I don't think we'll need battle gear in heaven. Okay, where was I? Here. Moreover, this is verse 12 now. I will make your battlements of rubies, or bright red, it says, and your gates crystal or carbuncles. I always wondered what that meant. And now I know it's crystal. So I didn't used to, when I read that the first time, like long, long time ago, I thought carbuncles, that's like a boil, you know, something I didn't want on anything made for me. And your entire wall of precious stones. And wall can mean literally border or boundary. So if we had a wall around our mansion, it'd be made of precious stones. All your sons will be taught of the Lord, and the well-being of your sons will be great. Now, of course, that can be daughters, your children. All your children will be taught of the Lord. I had to think this will mean my children will make it into heaven. You and all your household, it says in Acts, when one family was saved, one guy was saved, and he was told, I think it was by Peter, but I'm not sure, you go now, you will be saved, you and all your household. And I often wondered if that meant just the ones living under your roof, or all of your family. Still, I will pray for them just the same. Verse 14. In righteousness you will be established. You will be far from oppression, for you will not fear, and from terror, for it will not come near you. Okay, so all this terror going on, besides Psalm 91, you can go to this verse, Isaiah 54, 14, and claim it, okay? You will be far from oppression, for you will not fear, and from terror, for it will not come near you. If anyone fiercely assails you, it will not be from me. Whoever assails you will fail because of you. Because of you, he's saying. Whoever assails you will fall because of you. Because of your faith, you're living a righteous life, you're following that little narrow path that we're not supposed to get off of. You're picking up your cross daily and following him. You're obeying the commands of Jesus. You're living as holy as possible and repenting when you mess up. You will be protected by the Lord, and whoever assails you will fall because of you. Behold, myself is a capital M. Jesus is saying, behold, I myself have created the smith who blows, well, or father, or the spirit, God, we'll just say God, okay? I myself, or God, I have created the smith who blows the fires of coals and brings out a weapon for its work. And I have created the destroyer to ruin. I have created the destroyer to ruin. That's interesting. Now, this one I quote not every video, but almost. I'm trying to. No weapon that is formed against you will prosper. That's Isaiah 54:17. And every tongue that accuses you in judgment, you will condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their vindication is from me, declares the Lord. Now, when this was written, it was written to the Jews, but the Word of God is living and active and sharper than a two-edged sword. It is not a dead book of old words. It is a living book. And this is now pertinent for us. So you can claim the words of God for yourself. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their vindication is from me, declares the Lord. And who is Jesus Christ, according to the Bible? The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. That's what it says. I'll find it. Evidently, that's the name of a song. Where in the Bible? Okay, that's what I want. Revelation 19:16. Wait a minute. Revelation 19:16. Oh. There's a video on it. 2:58. Okay, well, I'll just look it up in where I'm at. Revelation 19. I wonder if they mean verse 16. Let's see. Yes. Revelation 19:16. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. So hallelujah, the Lord of Lords. That makes it appropriate for us because Jesus is our Lord. And with that, I'll say I plead the blood of Jesus over this video, myself, my computer, my internet connection, and over each and every single one of you. And I hope this encouraged you today. And I plead the blood over your devices and over your internet connections. And with that, I'll say bye for now. I'll talk to you later.